Despite repeated attempts by Sergeant Stein to try to halt the process, a panel voted 3-0 last week to recommend that he be discharged from the military, a move that would render him ineligible for his veterans' benefits.
Some of the things that you posted to your Facebook page, because you have a personal page that you posted to.
One, you called President Obama a domestic enemy. We have that up there. Another one where you wrote, and I'm not going to read this whole thing because there's a word that I wouldn't use in it, but you said this: as an active duty Marine, I say that word, Obama. And they say that the post specifically violated the Uniform Code of Military Justice, Article 134, which basically says you neglect the prejudice of good order and discipline in the armed forces. Are they wrong about that? I mean, you're a Marine. Are you supposed to be writing those kinds of things and much, much more, by the way, about the person?
Probably have dealt with clients in the past too who have had some real frustrations. Work can be a frustrating place, and sometimes you want to let out a little steam. What is your advice to them when they feel that way?
Yeah, well, Sunny, I really think that most of my clients who have faced this, you know, sometimes they're just not thinking. And I think definitely we have to take a second thought before we, you know, hit the send button or the post button. We really want to make sure that we're using wisdom and we're not bashing the boss, we're not bashing our jobs, and just be very careful. We all have stressful lives, and we just really have to be wise before we start making posts that are going to cost us our job or even our relationships.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. Men who died, who gave that right to me.
Join us this evening as we interview Sergeant Gary Stein. Hello, I'm Erin, and your host for tonight. On the 5th, we interview Sergeant Gary Stein. He has been threatened of an other than honorable discharge for going against Pentagon policy. Tonight, he joins us to answer some questions that made this 9-year vet go from sergeant to jobless. Here is Gary Stein. Hi, Gary. Thanks for coming.
No problem. Glad to be on
the
show.
Did you realize you're violating Pentagon policy that dates back to the Civil War?
Yes, I was aware of the Pentagon policy. However, the understanding of it to me was very vague.
Do you feel it was unfair that servicemen and women's rights are restricted?
Yes, I do. Marines and other armed forces and your normal day-to-day citizens, I feel, should have the same rights when it comes to voicing their opinion on whatever issue they feel is should be talked about. But yeah, there shouldn't be any restrictions for different types of citizens, even though our job is to fight for our country. However, voicing our opinion should be just the same as
your superiors told you to stop multiple times. What influenced you to break their chain of command?
While on duty, I know following superior ruling is what I am. That's my job. However, at home, I feel I can voice my opinion with no repercussions.
Okay. Speaking of voicing your opinion, you posted "Screw Obama" on your Facebook wall. What prompted you to say this about the president of our country?
As a Marine fighting for our country, I feel some of the decisions Obama has made over the past couple years have been questionable.
You started a page on Facebook called the Armed Forces Tea Party. What swayed you to create that?
Being a Marine, also voicing my opinion at the same time, was difficult, so putting it on Facebook and creating my own page allowed me to say what I wanted to say, not trying to cause any harm or for me to be in serious trouble as a soldier, but just to voice my opinion so other people may agree or disagree, to just venting.
I see. Stay tuned for more about Gary Stein after these commercial breaks. Welcome back to as we continue to interview Sergeant Gary Stein. Gary, what kind of reaction were you looking for after superimposing Palma's face on those movie posters? I mean, you went and took the incredible movie poster, a nice little Disney kid movie, changed it to The Horribles, and then slapped Obama's face on it.
I wasn't really looking for a big reaction as far as how big it got. I was actually, it actually kind of humored me to see what other people would think, voicing their opinion, but also if people disagreed, voicing their opinion as well.
Being a soldier, you have certain expectations. Do you feel you went against those expectations?
No, and yes, actually, because I wasn't fully understanding of the Pentagon policy when we took oath, but however, the First Amendment of Rights allows us to say and express what we want, no matter what type of American citizen you are.
Do you take back now what you said about Obama?
I actually do, considering the circumstances on how it turned out for me personally. I didn't intend on losing my job and losing all the benefits that came with this great job to serve our country, so yeah, I definitely would.
Do you feel the media had any part in over-embellishing what happened?
Of course. I mean, in today's society, media blows basically every story up, no matter how big or small. But I never intended to get this big. I just wanted it to be my personal Facebook wall, voicing my opinion to people, whether they agree with it or not.
Do you plan on continuing to keep your Facebook?
Definitely. I mean, voicing my opinion still is as strong as it before I was discharged, but I definitely want to still keep my same values for what I believe in as far as your voicing of opinion. And also, I think the Pentagon policy should be better enforced for up and coming soldiers as well.
Okay. Thank you for coming on the show.
No problem. It was a pleasure.
Join us next week as we interview Johnny Depp.
Hi, welcome back.
What do I say?
You were asking me about the posters.
Welcome back as we enter. Wait, welcome.
You can pause it.
Join us this evening tonight. Did you realize you were violating Pentagon policy that dates back to the Civil War?
Taking oath, we did. We were.
Stop saying we. It's you.
Oh, yeah, it's me.
Just say.
I found,
don't even say taking oath. Just say.
I found it.
Yes, I'm aware of the Pentagon.